Yes, Magnum, ma sha Allah, and it's ma sha Allah, it looks nice.
It's okay. I have a backup solution. It doesn't work, I have
another one. Jazakallah. No, I think it's good. Inshallah, it will work. Give it back up because it's.
Yeah. I'll put this one there.
Okay, so. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So
you can now set it.
Because this is heavy.
Yeah. Wait. Now it should work.
Is it okay?
No, it's okay. So we continue, inshallah. Our class. I have problem also with this one. Can I have your book here? What we wear? Okay. On the other hand, we still talking about what the conditions of Salah, huh? Prayer conditions. And how many conditions we finish? Huh? Okay. We are in, I think, this is in Kabar al-Awra, we finished Kabar al-Awra, right? طيب. On the other hand, prayer is invalid if performed at masjid whose qibla faces grave, for the Prophet ﷺ said, do not face grave in prayer. This is one that we spoke about last week. And we said it's not allowed, okay, to build masjid on graves. It is not allowed to build masjid and graves. Why? Because next generation, they will make connection between the grave and the masjid. And they think that this person who was buried in the masjid, that means he is, as they said, wali or saint. Or and by the time passing, people, they will deal with it in a shirk. And this is what's going on. You can see it in many of the Muslim countries, unfortunately, that people, they go and they go around the grave, and ignorant people, when they say the grave in the masjid, so they just go to that grave and make dua, and which this will lead to shirk. طيب. So it's not allowed to. طيب. In case there is a masjid and there is a grave, if the grave in the qibla, for sure it's forbidden to pray in that masjid. If the grave in the Qibla side, that's mean people, when they pray, the grave will be in front of them, between them and the Qibla. Then, no salah at this masjid. If the grave in the back, if they can get it out of the presence of the masjid, that's mean take it out, make wall, to leave it outside the masjid, then that's better. If they pray just not facing the it's okay, but it's not also recommended. This is the point. So I will move from this because the Sheikh is talking a lot about this idea. We'll go to the fourth condition of Salah. Facing the Qibla. Al-Qibla, they call it Qibla, whatever face you consider for you Qibla. Because we said qabl, ba'd. Qabl means front. So anything which is front of you, this is in your qibla. Tayyib. And this qabl, anything in the front called qabl. Anything in the back called dubur. وَلَا تُوَلُّ الْأَدْبَارِ. The back. So back, dubur, plural, adbar, front is what? Huh? Qabul or Qibla? It depends on the طيب. Among the conditions of the validity prayer is facing the Qibla, which is the Kaaba. Why the Sheikh mentioned the Kaaba specific here, word? Because the Qibla depends on where you are. If you are inside the Masjid and you can see the Kaaba, then you should direct and face where? The Kaaba itself, inside the Masjid, because you can see it. If you were outside the Haram, then you face the Masjid, which is the Qibla inside the Kaaba. If you are in Mecca, you face the area where the Haram, and if you are outside Mecca, you face Mecca. This is the Qibla. The Qibla at the beginning, you know that it was to Bayt al-Maqdis, al-Quds. And then Allah Azza wa Jal commanded that it is transferred to al-Masjid al-Haram. So this is related to al-Qibla. طيب. Allah Azza wa Jal said, وجهه in this سورة البقرة قد نرى تقلب وجهك في السماء فلنولينك قبلة ترضاها فولي وجهك شطر المسجد الحرام وحيثما كنتم فولوا وجوهكم شطرة. The meaning of this ayah. So turn your face toward المسجد الحرام and wherever you are turn your faces toward it. That means in Salah. So whoever is so near to the Kaaba that he can see it, it is obligatory for him to turn his whole body toward during prayer. That means anyone who pray in any direction other than al-Qibla, then it's the Salah is what? In bad. This is why it's very, very important to make sure that we are facing the Qibla. طيب. Now, turning the face, that doesn't mean turning the face, be careful. But that means the Qibla should be in front of you. So if somebody, for example, is turning like this and his face to the Qibla like this, this is not correct. When we say that means the whole body. Because the face by itself, during the Salah, for example, if by mistake or forgot, somebody forgot, and then he turned his face right or left at the time of Salah, does this invalidate his Salah? If you were in your prayer. And then you hear voice or somebody, and then you know it's by nature, and like this. Does this invalidate the Salah? This does not invalidate the Salah. No? Yeah. It's invalidate the Salah if you turn the whole body away from the Qibla. But if the body, the whole body, and you are facing the Qibla, and just by, this is what the Prophet ﷺ said, اختلاسٌ يختلسه الشيطان من صلاة أحدكم. The meaning, this is like a stealing of your Salah that Shaitan is taking from your prayer. So this will not invalidate the Salah. But if the person turns the whole body away from the side of the Qibla, then his Salah is what? Invalid. That's mean because why? Because he did not face the Qibla with his whole body. طيب. طيب. On the other hand, if one is near to the Kaaba, but there is something that hinders one from seeing it, one in this case has to try facing it as much as possible. However, if one is anywhere in the world so that one is away from the Kaaba, one then face direction believed to be of the Kaaba, which is to Mecca. And moving a bit leftward or rightward does not matter. You know, if there is something, a slight, it's okay. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ said, بَيْنَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ قِبْلَةً. Listen to this. The Prophet ﷺ said, بين المشرق والمغرب قبلة. What does it mean? Because you in Medina, they are facing where for the Kaaba? Huh?
South.
طيب. So the Prophet ﷺ said, between the east and the west, consider as Qibla. That means if you direct like this, or a little bit, or you know, as long as you are between this, then it is okay. So light or slight direction away from the Qibla, it doesn't matter, but not completely. So we should not blame ourselves sometimes. Some people, they are very picky about masjid. He said, the masjid, you see, look, we put this, it's not in the Qibla. No, as long as it is, like for example, if the Qibla is in the east, that's mean between the south and the north is Qibla, because you are facing the, what? The east, right? And therefore, their north and south and both side. So as long as you are between the north and the south, then it's okay because of the Qibla. The same thing if you are in the west, and same if you are in the north or in the south, then between the east and the west is considered as Qibla according to this hadith. This hadith was deemed sahih by Tirmidhi and narrated by many of the Prophet ﷺ Sahaba. Surely this hadith specified the Qibla for the Medina and all the places of the same direction and location. However, the Qibla for the east, for example, is between south and north, as we just explained. طيب. Generally, prayer is invalid without facing the Qibla, for Allah Azza wa Jal said, and wherever you are, turn your faces toward the Qibla. So this is a dalil from the Quran that the only direction to do our prayer is what? To face the Qibla, which is Al-Kaaba. However, right, wherever here indicate that the Qibla, salam, the Qibla is to be faced during prayer, no matter where one is, traveling by land, sea, air, eastward, westward, etc. Yet one is not obliged to face the Qibla if unable. If unable. So this is permission and excuse. That means the shart, the condition of the Qibla is waived in case the person was not be able to face the Qibla. For what? What reason? Either because he doesn't know the direction of the Qibla. But after he try all possible means to know the direction of the Qibla. If he couldn't figure out, then he made what? The best guessing. And then he prayed. Later on, if he discovered that he was not praying to the Qibla, his salah deemed valid. Why? Because he tried his best. طيب. طيب. A person, for example, traveling. If it was Salat al-Fariidah, then he should make sure that he faced the Qibla in all his Salah. But if he was in Salat al-Nafila, then it's okay. He starts with the Qibla, but then if he moved left or right, Salah is still valid and he can continue. طيب. A person, like you are in the aircraft. An aircraft go maybe left or right. And you are doing your salah, fariida. Right? And when you start, you try your best to face the Qibla. But then you don't know where the direction is going on. Your salah is what? Valid, because you try your best. Right? So the Qibla is a condition, but it is waived in case of uncertainty, in case of a person he couldn't face it, or because, in case that the person, for example, sick and nobody come to help him to face the Qibla, a person who in prison or he was tied and he cannot move and he cannot face the Qibla, the important thing is to do his prayer. طيب, what is the most important condition here? As you remember, we said what? Time. So if the person afraid that the time of the salah will expire, then he should do his prayer, try his best to face the qibla to the best of his ability. طيب. Such an able tied up for crucified in a way that one cannot face it. In such case, one is performed prayer facing the available direction, even if it is not the qibla. As this condition is inapplicable, in such case, according to juristic consensus. Similarly, if one is engaged in fire war, or one flee from flood, fire, wild animal, or any enemy, or and still that one is unable to face the qibla, one in such cases can perform prayer in the same state on his own. That means if there is danger, for example, there is the direction, the other direction, that was the direction of the qibla, there is enemies that you are afraid that at any time they will attack you, or gang of criminals, they are waiting for you to jump on your back, or there's wild animals, you are afraid they will come from this way if you turn your face, then it's okay to do your prayer facing that side to protect yourself, but also not to delay the salah. And this, my dear brothers, what does this signify? To show you what? The importance of salah, that Muslims should do it even at the time of what? Of danger. You know, salatul khawf. Fear. Salatul khawf. And there is certain regulation for this salah. Even at the time of war, you are engaged in war and fighting. Subhanallah. But also you should do your prayer. This will show you the importance of what? Of doing or performing our salah in the correct time. طيب. Also, if the person is ill, as we mentioned, one in such cases can perform the salah in the same state on his own, even if one is not facing the qibla. And one's prayer will be deemed valid as well. This is because the condition is nullified in a case of inability. Inability. So this condition is, the only condition that is not nullified is what? The niyya. Naam? The intention and the time. Time is very, very important. طيب, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, if I command you to something, then do it as much as you can. إِذَا أَمَرْتُكُمْ بِأَمْرٍ نَعْمٍ. So, when the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, if it's a matter of command, then you should do it. To what? To the best of your ability. And this, alhamdulillah, from the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal, to show you the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal, and to show you the easiness of this millah, millah to samha. Naam? يعني ما جعل الله عليكم في الدين من حرج. Allah did not make any problem on you because of the religion. So alhamdulillah, يعني very, always, if a person he cannot do what he was required, Allah Azza wa Jal will forgive. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. There's many ayat like this. رب ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملت على الذين من قبلنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا. يعني look, many ayat, many verses, many hadith would show you, alhamdulillah, the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal and the easy of the religion of Islam, that the Muslim is not command to do something beyond his ability or put him in dangerous situation. طيب, how to identify the qibla? طيب, how can we know the direction of the qibla? There are many ways through which one can know the qibla, among which are informing, that means somebody inform you, asking somebody, you are coming to town, a new town for the first time, and you don't know where's the direction of the qibla. Then you should ask. If a person come to a town and he just made guessing, and then he pray to a wrong direction, and then he discovered later on that he was not praying to the correct direction, that will come. You are Muslim and you don't know that. That is very important matter. This is very important to make sure that you get the information from trustworthy person and ask. طيب. Following the Qibla observed by Masjid and Mihrab. Al-Masjid, you know the building of the Masjid. Al-Mihrab, where the place of the Imam is prayed. So if you are in a town and you see a Masjid, you want to know the Qibla, then you'll go around, you will see the Mihrab, and you can know that this is the side or the direction of the Qibla. It said before, I'm not sure if this is, they took it now as decoration.
I think only the purpose of to know this is a Muslim church.
Nowadays they use it as a signal that this is a Muslim temple. That's it.
But the purpose
also. No, the purpose is to face the Qibla. The Hilal, the crescent, and the top of the Minara is to face the Qibla. This was the purpose of this. طيب. Astronomy, the Qibla can also be identified by means and by the stars, and they are. You see, before, nowadays, alhamdulillah, with all this technology talking everywhere, generally, it's become very, alhamdulillah, very easy, very simple. There are many applications, there are many devices that can help you to identify the Qibla. The fifth condition of Salah. Do you have any question about the Qibla before we move? Good background about this. Maybe if any of you come to any conclusion, it can help us. Did you reach any conclusion about this? You know, some people, they said you should face the east because Makkah is the middle, you call it east, to the east. Some they said no, the west, from the west side.
Philippines.
Naam?
Philippines.
Philippines, no problem, it's very clear, yeah, to the west, but in the east because in the middle, between the, you know, the. This is the problem that. But anyway, as long as they are facing the Qibla, inshallah there is no problem. But if there is shortest, for sure, the shortest way is preferred. Naam. Any question? طيب. Condition number 5 for the Salah. الشرط الخامس. Intention. Intention. To intend performing an act of worship to draw near to Allah. That means the purpose of the Salah is what? To please Allah Azza wa Jal, to do our duty, to do our obligation. And the niyyah, my brothers, is very, very important. Why? That means because this is are you coming just to pray any prayer? For sure, it's very important to, when you come to pray the Salah, you know what prayer you want to pray. This is very, very important. طيب. And the niyyah here is very important. If there is no niyyah, that means the Salah is invalid. The Salah is invalid. Does this mean that we should say and we talk and speak, oh, Allah, I want to pray at Dhuhr? No. Allah Azza wa Jalla, no. The intention, the place for the niyyah is where? In the heart. The intention is in the heart. طيب. The heart is the real place for intention. So one does not have to declare overtly, for this is regarded as an act of innovation in religion that had intent a bit earlier. It is conditioned that intention must last until the end of prayer. Now what does this mean? Because if the person during his prayer, if he tend to break from his salah, and even he didn't break from his salah is already finished, ended, invalid. A person started a salah within a year to pray for rak'ah, dhuhr. Right? And in the middle of the salah, somebody brought food there. Right? And he intended to leave the salah and go to eat. To end his salah, to finish. But he was shy. You know, he doesn't long to. We know that salah for the salah is for rak'ah. Right? Behind this imam or sheikh so and so in this masjid, and maybe also he will add the zip code. Yes, subhanAllah. And pray on the madhab Imam Hanafi or whoever, or Hanbali or whatever. All this are bid'ah. The intention is the heart. You come to pray the Lord, that's it. No need to add all this information, and you are telling Allah Azza wa Jal what you are doing. Allah Azza wa Jal knows what you are doing before you come down. Facing the car. Right? So next week, inshallah, if it is Salat, I mean, as we said, if it is not Ramadan, we'll meet the same time. If it was Ramadan, we'll meet after Salat Al Jum'ah, inshallah. Right? Jazakum Allah khair. We're welcome, brother Abu Hudayfa, inshallah. Alhamdulillah. As-salama, that Allah Azza wa Jal retain him safe to us. And maybe, do you have any idea about Ramadan program? To tell them, inshallah?
Comfortable and I'm going back to the Jum'ah.
Jazakallah khair.